Hello again, library families. My name is Miss Jessica, and today I wanted to do an experiment with you to help us better understand the environment. One of the ways we can be more sustainable is by understanding how our actions affect the world so that we can make better choices to not cause so many negative effects. So for our experiment today, we are going to need a bucket or container filled partway with some water, a ruler, some ice chunks, some rocks, and if you have any little animals to add in, you can use those too. We're going to be doing this experiment outside in the sun. Take your bucket of water and add in the rocks to one side of it. Then add in your big ice chunks to the other side. The chunks of ice should float to the top of the water. You can then put some animals on top of the ice as well as on the rocks. Using the ruler, measure how deep the water is right now. Write it down somewhere and then leave your bucket of water in a sunny place for 30 minutes. We'll check back and see what's happened.
So I checked back in on my bucket after about 30 minutes and the ice had almost completely melted. This is obviously much, much faster than it happens in real life, but it is very similar to how the ice is melting in the Arctic. My penguin couldn't even stand on the ice anymore because it's too small. This happens in the Arctic as well. When the ice melts too small, animals that rely on the ice caps to get across open water won't be able to use them anymore. And animals on land could lose their habitats as water levels rise, just like the penguin on the rocks did in my bucket. Measure your water level again to see just how high the water level rose as the ice melted in your bucket.
It's complicated about why the ice caps are melting, but at least partially it is due to human actions causing greenhouse gases. This is pollution from things like our cars that use gas to run and then as a result put pollution out into the air. This pollution makes Earth warmer and is making the ice caps melt more. It's important that we think about things like this to be more sustainable. We can walk or bike instead of driving somewhere. We can recycle and reuse as much as possible. And we can make sure to turn off light switches when we leave the room so that we're only using electricity when we need it. I hope this experiment taught you some new ways that you can be more sustainable and more kinder to the Earth. Goodbye, everyone!